even know what's next. I gotta pause right here. If you don't like God the way I like God, you ain't gonna scream the way I scream. You ain't gonna worship the way I worship. But if you bless God when you don't know what November gonna look like, when
has taken many forms.
People have been denied the right to vote for well nigh 80 years.
First, they used the poll tax to keep black folks from voting. Then, it was the literacy test, racial terrorism, and violence.
I don't want everybody to vote.
New day, same old dirty tricks.
There are those in power who are doing their darndest to discourage people from voting.
Calls for investigations after claims of voter suppression.
President Trump sabotaging efforts to vote by mail.
If your vote didn't matter, they wouldn't try so hard to take it from you. Vote early. Vote like your life depends on it. I'm exercising my right to vote, and you should too. Not because I want you to, but because he doesn't.
Birth family, why don't you clap your hands right where you are and thank God for this ministry moment. I know you just watched the announcements, and I know that you are excited and in spiritual anticipation for what God is getting ready to do in this house and in your life on November 8th. I am excited to say that God is getting ready to change what has happened in the last 365 days in just one day. Why don't you just thank God and say, Lord, I receive the word that our pastor has spoke over our life. I don't know about you, but my faith is up. I need God to do something. Write it down in the chat. Supernatural. I need God to put his super on my natural. I am expecting, as this moment is sacred, I am expecting for God to speak to me in a way that not only shows me that he hears my prayer, but God answers also. Listen, family and friends, I want you to do me a favor. I want you to position your heart for November 8th, because this is a spiritual moment. On November 8th, our church, our guests, our members, all of those who watch are going to sow a seed above your tithes and offering so that we, New Birth, can continue to support the vision of this house. How many of you can say that you've been blessed by the ministry word of our senior pastor, Dr. Jamal Bryant? How many of you can say it seems like he sleeps in your closet and he rides in your back car? How many of you can say that you have seen someone touched by our TKT ministry? Did you know that we are almost 500,000 people that we have served since March? I am telling you, this is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes. Moses was in a battle one time, and things were getting tough. Moses is a visionary. Moses cast the thought, but Moses needed help. His arms got tired.
And the Bible describes how two gentlemen named Aaron and Ur began to hold up Moses' arm so the fight could be won. Our pastor needs you. I want you to hear me right now. Obey God. I need you to hear me right now. Obey God. Our pastor is fighting social justice. Our pastor is fighting homelessness. Our pastor is fighting food disparity. Our pastor is fighting the disparagement in our digital divide with our students. Our pastor is not on the sideline. He's on the front line. And New Birth, we need your help. On November 8th, we have a goal of $500,000, and I know we can do it. If you partner with us in this giving moment, it would allow us to continue to do creative ministry. It would allow us to provide holistic programs. It would allow us to minister to those who have need. And with your seed, with your faithful, committed giving, and not just your tithe and your offering, but with your faithful and committed giving, we can continue to win souls and make disciples. Right on the screen, even now, are our giving options. I want you to purpose in your heart what God is calling you to do. God has declared this word. He has said it very clearly, that what man can do in a year, our God can do in a day. I want you to see, even right now, we have different giving options. We have a giving option of $13,000. If that's you, don't delay. We have a giving option right now of $3,000, $3,650. If that's you, don't delay. If you have the opportunity to sow a seed of $1,365, do it now. I want you to make the pledge. We're even challenging our youth to sow. We're saying, listen, all millennials, all those who are unemployed, get a seed of $36.50. Listen, it's not equal sacrifice. It's not equal giving, it's equal sacrifice. I want you to put your sacrifice on the altar right now. I want you to say, God, I not only give you my seed, but I give you my best. Listen, I want to ask you a question before we move forward. I want you to go to NB365-71441. And I want you to look at that giving options, and I want you to make a commitment, and I want you to show up and sow up. And I want you to believe that the supernatural is going to happen. When you give to our giving options, it's safe, it's secure, it's swift, and it will rebound a supernatural harvest back in your life. Can I ask you the question now? If your seed was connected next Sunday to your next 365 days, what type of seed would you give? I want to thank you in advance for trusting God, for believing the integrity of our visionary. New Birth, you're an amazing church, and we love you. Right now, will you do me a favor wherever you are? Will you just lift up your hands wherever you are? I don't want you to give God a later praise. Even where you are, thank God for what he's done for you from March to now. Don't give him a later praise. Give him a right now praise.
One praise from my breakthrough. I'm just a praise away from my blessing. All I need to do is reach down inside into the depths of my soul and bring forth all right now. It's already in me. Those of you that are watching this morning, you are just one praise from your breakthrough. You're just one praise away from your blessing. All you need to do is reach down inside into the depths of your soul and bring forth all right now praise that's already in you. So let's give him praise. All right now praise, praise. All right now praise, praise. All right now praise. You
You ought to type that on the screen, everybody. Let's give Jesus praise. All right now, praise, praise. All right now, praise, praise. All right now, praise. Just stay right there. Come on, let's worship together, everybody. Let's give Jesus praise.
All right now,
why don't you just lift your hands?
Believe anything can happen. Come on, clap your hands and give him glory. I'm believing anything can happen. Healing can happen. Breakthrough can happen. Deliverance can happen. Salvation can happen. Somebody just shout out loud, anything can happen. I'm believing that for yourself. I'm believing it for your family. I even believe that for me. I'm excited about our worship encounter and what it is that God has expressed while it is that we have been together. I am excited about the new things that God is doing. This morning, for the very first time, we are in virtual reality. And so we're glad to partner with OHUB to get that done. In the next couple of weeks, we're going to be able to interface so your young people will be able to have worship in virtual space while it is that we are in real time. Those of you that want information about it, you can go to campus.ohub@at. I ask that you'll please look it up. OHUB is an amazing breakthrough of technology. They're partnering with us in ministry on today. I ask that you'll share, text, tag somebody. The word that God has given us for this day is not meant for anybody but you. You need this word. I need you to take my word for it. Would you meet me in 1 Samuel chapter 10? 1 Samuel, I'm sorry, chapter 15. 1 Samuel chapter 15. And I want to illuminate two verses, verses 10 and 11. 1 Samuel 15, verses 10 and 11. It is my earnest prayer that you have already participated in early voting. I'm so honored that New Birth is a polling station for DeKalb County. On Tuesday morning, our doors will be flung open for those of you who are registered to vote and want to exercise that vote. On tomorrow, it is my esteemed privilege, if you're anywhere in the Atlanta metropolitan area, I want you to meet me at 4 o'clock tomorrow in Turner Field. It is the last get out to vote rally for the state. And our guest will be none other than President Barack Obama. It's going to be an amazing day. Anybody that can join us at Turner Field, I want you to go and do that. Amen. John Legend is going to be there. Our own candidate, Reverend Raphael Warnock and John Ossoff will be there. I'll be sharing, and I want you to come in. We're going to try to stream it on all of our platforms, so those of you from around the world will be able to peek in and see how it is that the vote is being mobilized. 1 Samuel 15, verses 10 and 11. Then the word of the Lord came to Samuel. The Lord said to Samuel, hear this, I regret that I made Saul king, because he has turned away from me and not carried out my instructions. Samuel was angry and he cried out to the Lord all that night. I want to preach for a little while today using as a subject, pouring out spoiled milk. Pouring out spoiled milk. I remember when I first moved to Atlanta, I hadn't fully relocated from Baltimore. There was a protracted amount of time from the moment I moved to Atlanta to when I could get back home. It took about 6 weeks for me to get acclimated here and to be able to go back there and gather the last of my things. I remember entering into my house, and as soon as I turned the doorknob and took one step in, I was met with the most pungent aroma of death I'd ever encountered. I thought there must be a corpse somewhere in my home. And upon deeper inspection, I opened the refrigerator door only to discover that it was a gallon of spoiled milk. You see, milk is at its freshest the day that it is pumped from the cow, and usually can last about 16 days after that. It must be kept around 45 degrees Fahrenheit, but can't go below 32 degrees. If the temperature shifts too much, it will expedite the spoiling process. Milk spoils when bacteria converts to lactose, then into glucose, producing a lactic acid. Here's the tricky part that I wanted you to be aware of. The tricky part is that spoiled milk looks healthy. It is is only until you smell it that you know that it changes. Because of the legal toxicity by law, an expiration date has to be posted on the carton. I wanted to say to you this Sunday morning that milk is a lot like some people. They are good until they are not. They can't handle the shifts, and they spoil quick if they are not given consistent attention. The dangerous part is that they appear to be the same, but the aroma and scent dramatically shifts. In Revelations, isn't it amazing that God never looks at a worshiper, he smells them. Says that your worship is like a sweet perfume. People who have become spoiled become antagonistic. They become distant. They become sarcastic. They become nasty. They become demeaning. They become condescending. They become aloof. And some of them become super spiritual. Life would be so much easier if everything you have now came with an expiration date. If it came with an expiration date, we would know when to pour it out. An expiration date for the job that is a dead end. An expiration date for the career that no longer challenges you. An expiration date for the apartment you have outgrown. An expiration date on the car which was faulty when you bought it. An expiration date for a ministry that no longer challenges you to grow. An expiration date for a friendship that was seasonal that you thought would be eternal. Can you imagine how much healthy your heart would be if you had an expiration date over people whose presence defile your space, disrupt your peace, denigrate your harmony, desecrate your soul, and demolish your self-esteem. I came this morning because I needed you to know today is the expiration date. There are some things in heaven that have just run out for you. This is the day you pour out every ounce of depression. You pour out every semblance of self-sabotage. You pour out everything that is unhealthy in your home. You pour out everything that is bitter in your mind. Today, November 1st, is the expiration date where everything that is not healthy for you is going to get exposed. That had to be the mind frame of the Roman Republic, which is widely hailed as the blueprint for modern democracy, when they instituted a law that imposed a single term for elected officials. Back in 1951, when the U.S. House of Representatives actually did work. In 1951, they passed the 22nd Amendment that restricted presidential terms to only two. They were short-sighted because they restricted presidential terms, but there is no restriction on vice presidential terms. There's no term limit for Congress. And there's no term limit for the Senate. In a recent national poll, it was discovered that 82% of Americans agree with term limits. 89% of Republicans want them. And 76% of Democrats believe that term limits are necessary. It's on both sides, which shows that it is not a party agenda, but it is a people's mandate.
presently at this tick of the watch, Congress has, hear this, somewhere around a 54% approval rating. Congress is less popular than traffic jams. Congress is less popular than root canals and less popular than hemorrhoids. And yet people still keep voting for them. What is amazing is that incumbents have a 98% reelection rate. What I wanted you to write down, what I needed you to hear, what I want you to marinate on is that when we are slow to move, God is steady to replace. Even when you don't want to change it, God will change it. He has equipped us with the power to replace. I don't know who needs that, but I need you to know that I'm talking directly to you. You are anointed with the power to replace. Tuesday, America has the power to pour out sour milk. Sour milk that is stinking up the White House. At the risk of being canceled by the culture, might I simply suggest it might have been good for Trump to get into office. It was good for him to get into office because it exposed the embodiment of white toxic masculinity. It was good for him to get into office because it pulled the covers off America's original unredeemed sin, which is racism. It was good for him to get in office because it showed and put on Front Street the lack of moral authority in white evangelicals who copy and pasted scripture for their own political narrative but forgot the wholeness of the intent to remember those who are oppressed and marginalized. You can't tell me that you are pro-life and you want to make sure that babies in the fetus survive, but don't say nothing about black men who are choked in the street. Don't tell me you're pro-life, but I haven't heard none of you evangelicals stand up for Breonna Taylor. Don't tell me you are for pro-life, but you don't say anything about the thousands of black men who are in jail for nonviolent offenses. What it is that you represent is a false gospel and an air-thin theology. What has happened under President Trump is America has been forced to look in the mirror when it has been enamored by looking out the window, deputizing itself to be the police of the world on what everybody else is not doing, but failing to see how they suppress democracy right in our own backyard. Nobody has said nothing, evangelicals, about missing post office stations in black communities or sorting machines or stop counting of the census. Nobody has said anything. Stop looking out the window and look in the mirror. Has failed to equip the nation, this president has failed to equip the nation for the pandemic, refused to release adequate stimulus, diminished the integrity of the census, pulled through the least qualified Supreme Court justice in the history in 30 days, but in 88 days can't agree on a stimulus for those who are unemployed. They have stopped funding Social Security, disrupted the Voting Rights Act, want to dismantle health care. And the only black people you think you can talk to is Lil Wayne, Ice Cube, and 50 Cent. At some point, you gotta pour out spoiled milk. On this coming Tuesday, America's gotta realize how nasty the nation smells. We keep putting out God bless America, and God is waiting for America to bless him. He already gave us the prescription. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves, seek my face, turn from their wicked ways, then I'll heal the land and you'll hear from heaven. I got to pause right here. I wonder if there's anybody here who's got enough nerve to give God glory. Here's your shout. When life stinks, will you praise him? When your money stinks, will you magnify him? When your relationship stinks, will you bless him? Even when you can't stand the stench of your own existence. Then in Luke chapter 22, verse number 53, Jesus said to those who were trying to kill him, I want you to look, this in my text, but it's an auxiliary companion text, Luke 22, verse number 53, Jesus said to those who were trying to kill him, but this hour belongs to you. Hear this. Jesus said to the enemies of the cross, this hour belongs to you. We suggest to us, ladies and gentlemen, that even darkness gets an hour. But what you have forgotten, hear this, is that the hour for darkness has come to an end. Pastor, I need you to help me with that. What did you just say? I said the hour of darkness has come to an end. That's why last night while you were asleep, God redeemed the time. It was 1 hour when you got to bed, but a different hour when you woke up this morning. God told me to tell the principalities of darkness, your hour has come to an end. Your hour of vilifying those who are oppressed, of marginalizing those who are immigrants, for debasing those who are women. God says, I'm going to redeem those who stand with me. And you ought to be reminded, if God be for you, who can be against you? God is saving the last laugh for me. I don't care what you got away with, Donald Trump, for the last 4 years. And the Republicans that were complicit on trying to keep us stifled. But God said, give me 3 days. You already know what happens in 3 days. Everything you thought was dead will come back to life again, because this is the hour. You don't believe it still? Jesus shows up. And when Jesus shows up, Mary and Martha run out to him. And they say, it's too late. I hope you can see it. By now, his body stinks. It's nothing but sour milk. But Jesus said, show me where you laid him. I'm telling you that God is getting ready to walk through the cemetery of these supremacist churches and say, until you put up a picture of a black Jesus, until you recognize that he was wounded for your transgressions and bruised for your iniquities, that the chastisement of our peace is upon his shoulders, America will still stink. There's no discussion about reparations on the backs of the people who built the nation. Somehow or another, it seems to be out of budget. When you showed us 8 weeks ago, you could find $2 trillion without there ever being a recession in the nation. That you can send money to Israel, but you'll allow all of Africa to stay impoverished and levy wedges against them, that they'll always be indentured servants. But I need you to know there's one thing about tables. Tables always turn. Because the Bible says, and Ethiopia shall stretch forth their arms. I don't know who needs to receive it, but God told me to tell you, you don't know your position. You are the head and not the tail. You are above and not beneath. You are a lender and not a borrower. 1 Samuel chapter 15, the Lord sent the prophet, the sitting king, whose name was Saul, and said to Saul, I am going to repay the Amalekites. Hear me well. I am getting ready to deal with those who mishandled you when you were trying to get yourself together. They took advantage of you while you were vulnerable. They tried to monopolize you while you were weak. And God says, I'm getting ready to give you strength, because they didn't know who you were. When you were coming out of Egypt, they saw you disheveled. They saw you broke. They saw you looking like a mishap, but they didn't know that even in my broken state, I'm anointed. Even when I don't have that much, I'm still anointed. Even when I'm not prospering materialistically, spiritually, I'm a millionaire. I'm telling you, people are going to be sorrowful for how they mishandled you, because they underestimated the gift of God that was on your life. You are not a victim. You are more than a conqueror. You are an overcomer. I'm telling you, you ain't gonna have to chase nobody down. God says, I got this. They thought they got away with it because you didn't say nothing. But the year will not end. I wish somebody would shout about it. The year will not end without them having the realization they should have treated you better. They should have loved you better. They should have handled you better. They should have valued you more. Saul got the word of God to go after the Amalekites because they mistreated the children of Israel. And the Lord says, I need y'all to hear this. I'm reading the word. The Lord said to him in 1 Samuel chapter 15, get all of them. I knew y'all wasn't going to like that. Get all of them. The ones that looked at you side-eyed. The ones that didn't respond to your messages. The ones that pretended like they didn't read your email. The ones who knew you were struggling but didn't do anything to help you. Get all of them. The ones that tried to talk sideways to your children and discredit you because of your failures and your shortcomings. Get all of them. The ones that wouldn't help you even though you helped them. The ones that talked about you after you confided in them. Get all of them. Saul said to him, I'm going to go deal with them. But you sure you want me to get all of them? The Lord said, get all of them. I'm sure. Mitch McConnell, get all of them. God help me. Yeah. State's attorney in Kentucky, get all of them. All of the banks that, in fact, have taken out all of their branches and dropped ATMs, get all of them. The rappers that ate off the hood and now got amnesia and feel as if they can do it on their own, get all of them. Get all of them. And when it was time for Saul to go back to war, he began, hear this, to only kill those that were weak. He only killed those that were despised, but he spared the king. Not only did he spare the king, he spared the best of the flock. And the Lord said something I've never heard him say before and since. He said, I regret I ever anointed him. I want you to know why it is that God was displeased with Saul. The reason why he was displeased with Saul is the reason why he is displeased with some of us. He's upset with Saul because Saul only went after the easy stuff. But the thing that was the hardest is that in which he did not target. I wish I had a better feel-good message. But on this November 1st, God is telling you that between now and December 31st, I don't want you going after low-hanging fruit. I need you to handle the king of your depression, the king of your stress, your anxiety, and your sabotage. Whatever is at the root of it, I want you to root it out. He gives Samuel this message. He says, Samuel, I no longer want Trump. I no longer want him to be king, because he thinks he's king of kings. I'm telling you, some people are getting ready to lose their position. They're getting ready to lose their title, getting ready to lose their seat of influence because they've gotten so puffed up and think that it's all about them. But God said, I will humble you to your knees until you can't get on your feet. I want your position. There's getting ready to be a transfer of power. God is getting ready to shift something. I don't know how many of you all want to receive it, but I'm getting ready to tell you God is getting ready to shift something. And this is the week it's going to happen. Hallelujah. God says right now, just for the worshipers, I am pouring out the sour milk. Whatever it is that has been contaminated, whatever it is that is spoiled, whatever it is that is rotten, whatever it is that has passed its expiration date is getting ready to be poured out. My time is up, but this message is not. God told me to tell you, embrace yourself, because I am not going to give you fresh milk. I'm going to give you fresh oil. And those of you that need the oil of God to touch you like it has never before, I need you to lift up your head, O ye gates. Be ye lifted up, that the King of glory can come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord mighty in battle. The Lord is his name. Anointing, fall fresh on me. Let the power of the Holy Ghost, let it fall. Hallelujah. Let it fall on me. Let it fall on me. The anointing is getting ready to fall. I need to just hear 50 worshipers in this room. A fresh anointing is getting ready to fall. It's getting ready to touch your house. It's getting ready to touch your career. It's getting ready to touch your finances. I need a fresh anointing. I need a fresh anointing. I need a fresh anointing. Come on, lift up that hand. Hallelujah. I've got a small assembly of worshipers with me today. And I need you to hear the sound of worship that's going to overturn sour milk. We're worshiping God that there will not be any interruptions to the electoral process on Tuesday. I can't hear nobody. I said, open up your mouth. I'm praying right now that there will be no underhanded tactics to shift the election on Tuesday. That there'll be no intimidation. Come on, open up your mouth. Pour out the spoiled milk. Hey.
Give us fresh power.
believing that a fresh anointing is getting ready to pour in this country. That revival is getting ready to break out. That souls are getting ready to be saved all over the earth. That people are going to be leaned into the glory room of God. I don't know how you feel about it, but there is nothing worse than a stale anointing. I need a fresh anointing for this hour. I need a fresh anointing for this season. I need a fresh anointing for the position that I'm in. I need a fresh anointing so I don't lose my mind. I need a fresh anointing so I don't betray my self-worth. I need a fresh anointing. Come on, everybody, pour it out, Lord.
Pour it out, Lord.
Fresh oil over your life and over your home. Out with the old, in with the new. Here's what I want you to do. This is the first Sunday of November, the law of first mention. Something fresh, something new is getting ready to happen. It's a new season. It's a new day. Fresh anointing is getting ready to come your way. It's a season of power, season of prosperity. I got good news. It's already here. Come on, all of our tithers, all of our seed sowers, all of our givers, all of the prompts are beneath me in this moment. If you want God to pour something new into your life, pour something new into your family, something new into your imagination, something new into your marriage, something new into your home, I want you to sow this morning. I need you to give your tithe, give your gift in this moment, that I am expecting God to do it. I'm believing that he's going to do it. In him, there is absolutely no failure. I don't know where you are, but there are those of you who are not growing, who have been turned off by the church because of the scent, because of the aroma. They're preaching a gospel that is not relevant to where you are, not speaking to your needs, your problems, your perplexities. But today, the light bulb has gone off. This is my church. This is where God is going to prune me. This is where God is going to stretch me. This is where God is going to develop me. I got to tell you, transparently, I'm going to be your pastor. I'm telling you right now, I want New Birth to be your church. But do you know what I want more than that? I want Jesus to be the Lord of your life. I want heaven to be your final destination. I want it to be your home. I want you to join the church right now. We've got counselors that are standing by. They want to process you in and welcome you into the family because we're believing that God is going to do absolutely anything but fail. Anything but fail. Next Sunday is going to be a Sunday of signs and wonders. It's going to be a Sunday of miracles. We're believing God for 365. Let me ask Pastor Stokes, Pastor Turner, if you'll bring me those two boxes very quickly, please. Thank you so very much. I want you to partner with me in this project. that we're going to do over the holiday season that's going to be absolutely amazing. Pastor Lemons has already shared with you 500,000 people have been fed by our King's Table. 500,000 people. Come on, give God some praise. 500,000 people have been fed by our King's Table. Now, we've got another project for this holiday season. Everybody in your home has a shoebox. You have a shoebox in your home. It's in the closet. It's in the basement. It's in the trunk of your car. Some of y'all are hiding a shoebox from your spouse. Go get that shoebox. I want you to get your shoebox, and here's what I want you to do. I want you to cover it in red wrapping paper or green wrapping paper. All I need you to do, hear me, is I want you to get a shoebox and I want you to fill it with toys and educational materials for children. Toys and educational material for children. If it is a girl, you're wrapping it in red. If it's for a girl, you're wrapping it in red. If it is for a young man, you're wrapping it in green. But here's what I want to do. I want 1,000 shoeboxes. 1,000 shoeboxes. Oh, come on. Come on, Saba Church, make some noise. 1,000. We want to be a blessing to disadvantaged young people. We want to be a blessing to those who have been impacted because of the economy. And the amazing thing that we're going to do is that these 1,000 boxes, we are going to be a blessing to children all over the world, not just here in Atlanta. But we are partnering with churches and organizations in places that have been hardest hit by the global economy in this COVID-19 pandemic. I need you to please make sure you get it. It is very easy for you to do. All I ask is that once you fill it, do not seal the top of it so that we're able to see what is the age range. But I don't want it to just be toys, but I need you to put some learning information in it, put a book in it. Somebody has a Bible in there. Somebody else has a video game. But ask that you'll be creative. Make it a project for your family, a project for your children. Make it a project at your job. But I want you to do your own arts and crafts at home. Some of you can do multiple boxes. You can do 4, 2, 4, 6, 8. I need you to do as many. All I ask is take the shoes out the box. Please take the shoes out the box. I'm going to come back and get them shoes next year. But I need that box filled with toys so that we can be a blessing. New Birth, if you know that this is something we can do, come on, let's celebrate and give God glory. I'm thankful you've worshiped with us. I need you, please, if you have not voted Tuesday, you have the power to change. You have the power to make a difference. Tuesday, with your vote, you're going to pour out spoiled and sour milk. Ask that you'll please vote. Those of you who are in DeKalb County, New Birth is a voting station. Ask that you will come and meet us here. Church's Chicken has partnered with us. We're giving out chicken sandwiches. If you needed some enticement, amen, I want you to please come. I've got an army of volunteers. New Birth has some of the greatest spirit of charitable giving of anybody. If you want to be a volunteer on Election Day, we've got a fleet of buses. I need drivers, and I need bus marshals, and I need those who will help dispatch water for those who are waiting in line. If you want to volunteer, please go to newbirth.org. If you have not filled out your pledge, I need you to please go to New Birth and fill out your pledge. Next Sunday, I'm telling you, it's going to be absolutely amazing. If nobody told you today, I want you to know your pastor loves you. Not only do I love you, but I'm praying for you. And I'm believing this week, you're going to get in touch with a fresh anointing. Would you stand all over your feet? Stand on your feet all over. I can't believe it's been 8 months, but let's go together. Everybody, repeat after me. Walk with God, and he'll walk with me. Talk with God, and he'll talk with me. Listen to God, and he'll listen to me. Work for God, and he'll work for me. Love God, because he first loved me. I want you to lift that hand as high as you see yourself going. I'm telling you, this week you're going to get a fresh anointing. This week, something amazing is going to happen. Thank you, Brother Smith, for coming and worshiping with us. Now, unto him who's absolutely able to do anything but fail, may God make you sleepless until you help somebody. May God make you restless until you help yourself. May God irritate you until you have enough sense to worship him. And may God bless you until you have to give stuff away. Henceforth, now and forevermore. And all the blessed people of God said, amen. Get ready for your fresh anointing.
New Birth, we're just a few days away from our 365 celebration. It's your opportunity to help provide resources to help us keep going and growing, to conquer our church debt, and to help us become a more creative and holistic ministry. Please, won't you make a pledge today? All you have to do is text NB365 to 71441. What man can do in a year, my God can do in a day. You can also visit newbirth.org to complete a commitment card. And we don't want you to forget to pick up your free 365 wristband at our King's Table from 10 a.m. until 12 p.m. or the Call to Conquer bookstore from 8 a.m. until 1 p.m. on Saturday. And don't miss our latest 365 prayer call and day of fasting Tuesday, November 3rd at 7:30 a.m. The conference dial-in number is 712-775-7438. Dr. Brian has been delivering a powerful word, marching orders, and prayer for our families each and every week. Check this out. Our exclusive 365 fall merch and My Pastor Dope hoodies are a must for your fall wardrobe. Available online or at the Call to Conquer bookstore on Saturdays from 8 a.m. until 1 p.m. And while you're there, get the book of the month, The 48 Laws of Black Empowerment by Robert Greene. Oh, and you know what we want you to do? We want you to pull up at the King's Table. Each and every Saturday, the King's Table is open and ready to serve you with free groceries. All you gotta do is pull up Saturdays from 10 a.m. until 12 p.m. Just pop the trunk and we'll fill you up. Everybody's welcome at the King's Table. And that's it this time for our video announcements.